Welcome to Sunrise Meditations on the beautiful and serene Ender's Island. Today we celebrate the feast of Saint Matthias, Apostle. And I'm your host, Deacon Francis Valliere. Our Lectio Divina is from the Gospel according to Saint John, chapter 15, verses 9 through 17. Let us begin our prayer today in the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O God, who assigned Saint Matthias a place in the College of the Apostles, grant us through his intercession that rejoicing at how your love has been allotted to us, we may merit to be numbered among the elect. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. And now let us listen and attend to our gospel passage proclaimed by Michael Toole.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you, and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment: love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends, because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you: love one another."
Our first reading today from the Acts of the Apostles recounts the choosing of Matthias to fill the vacant place left by the treachery and death of Judas. This all took place soon after the ascension of Jesus, but before the coming of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. Matthias, who may have been one of the 72 disciples mentioned by Saint Luke in his Gospel, then took over with the other 11 the responsibility of an apostle, which was to hand on with accuracy and in its entirety the message of Jesus' life, his teachings, suffering, death, and his resurrection as the incarnate Son of God. This is what we now call tradition with a capital T. Perhaps the very heart of that tradition is expressed in our gospel reading. It is part of the long discourse at the Last Supper, which is recorded for us by Saint John. It begins with Jesus saying, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love." The word for love throughout the passage is in the original Greek, agape. This is a very special kind of love. It is not a grasping, clinging love. On the contrary, it is an outreaching love, unconditionally wanting the well-being of the other. This is the love which the Father extends to Jesus, and it is the love that Jesus extends to all of us. And we are to stay, to remain in that agape, in that love. And how are we to stay in that love? We do it by keeping the commandments of Jesus. Just as Jesus himself remains in his Father's love by keeping his Father's commandments. And that begs the question, what are these commandments? They are not the commandments of the Old Testament. They are not the Ten Commandments. In fact, there is only one which is all-embracing. This is my commandment: love one another as I have loved you. Jesus is telling us love with agape love. The whole of the gospel, the whole of the teaching of Jesus exists right there in that one word. If that was all that we had of the gospel, it would be enough. And Jesus goes further. No one has greater love, agape, than this: to lay down one's life for one's friends. A degree of love which Jesus will soon show each of us. And who are his friends? You are my friends, he says, if you do what I command you. That is, all those who unconditionally love their brothers and sisters. And if that is the measure of Jesus' love for us, it is also to be the measure of our love for each other. If we all kept this commandment, our world would be transformed. We would become a world of people who spent their lives caring for each other's needs. What a different world it would be. But there is another definition of Jesus' friends. He says, I have called you friends because I have told you everything I have heard from my Father. And the most precious thing Jesus has told us is that central command of love, loving each other. To have heard that message is a huge privilege, but also a huge responsibility, because it is a message that the whole world needs to hear. As Jesus put it himself, by this will all know that you are my followers, that you have love for one another. This agape love that he spoke of, this unconditional love that he spoke of, this love that brings unconditionally everything to the needs of others. This is to be the distinctive mark of our communities. It begs the question, would it describe mine? This is the message that Matthias and his fellow apostles inherited and which they passed on. It is for us to spread the same message, and it is done most effectively not by words, but by the witness of our interacting life together. After our closing prayer, reread the scripture passage and contemplate its message. Concentrate on a thought that comes to you either through a verse or even a word that touches you, and ask the Holy Spirit to show you how it pertains to you and how you may spiritually grow closer to Him. Now let us complete our divine reading today with a closing prayer, and let us pray. Never cease, O Lord, we pray, to fill your family with divine gifts. And through Blessed Matthias's intercession for us, graciously admit to us a share in the lot of the saints in light, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And may the peace of the Lord be upon you always. And may his blessings fill your day with peace and joy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.